We need to know this technique because we
I'm Green Dean, and welcome to my 115th video here at eattheweeds.com. This is my second video about Smilax. Let's call it Smilax 2. You can watch the first video for itemizing and the like. In this one, I'm going to focus on harvesting it and also how you can tell it apart from a common look-alike leaf Virginia creeper. In fact, I'm going to show you this several times, then do some cooking.
Let's get down to some basics here. Here's how your Smilax grows. There's the vine. We have a stem, a leaf, two tendrils. We go up a little ways, then the opposite side, stem, leaf, two tendrils. Pretty easy to figure out. Let's see how the Virginia creeper grows. We get a vine. We get a stem and three leaves that actually turn out to be five. And on the exact opposite side, we get a stem with tendrils. And some of these tendrils will develop leaves. Then we go up a ways and we have the opposite. We have a stem, leaves, and the stem with tendrils. This is toxic. This is the Virginia creeper. Let's take a look at the other one back again. The Smilax, particularly my local one, vine, straight, short stem, one leaf, two tendrils. Go up a little ways, other side, short stem, one leaf, two tendrils. Smilax, very edible. Virginia creeper, vine, stem, three leaves that actually turn into five. On the opposite side, stem with multiple tendrils that eventually develop with some leaves. Go up a little ways on the opposite, and then it flips, leaves on this side, tendrils, stem with tendrils on this side. But they're always opposite, whereas the Smilax is alternating. So now let's go look at the real thing. Here we have the two vines again, except these are real, not drawings. This is the Smilax, this is the Virginia creeper. Here I've got the vine, one short stem, one leaf, two tendrils. Opposite side, alternating over here, I've got one short stem, one leaf, two tendrils. And that pattern will continue out to the growing end. And back here they'll be larger and over there they'll be smaller. Whereas here, I have the exact opposite. Well, not the exact opposite, but its growth pattern is very different. This is the Virginia creeper and toxic. Here I have leaves on one side and tendrils on the opposite in pairs. Then leaves on one side, then tendrils on the other. One other little thing, when the Virginia creeper gets older, its leaves have teeth and the Smilax leaves don't have teeth, or at least this species doesn't. This is a classic bullbriar, exactly what I'm looking for. First of all, you'll notice that my leaves are on opposite sides. The leaves have a stem. And on that stem, there are two tendrils. So I'm going to put my hand behind them there. See those two tendrils? So I'm getting a leaf stem, a singular leaf, and two tendrils. This is a younger, smaller version of what we just saw. Perhaps we can get a little better idea. I have a leaf stem here, and then on the other side, a few inches away, I have a leaf stem. And then on the other side, I have a leaf stem. And then on the other side, a leaf stem. Each leaf stem has got two tendrils growing off it. You can see those right there now. Two tendrils. So I'm looking for alternating leaf stems with two tendrils growing off each leaf stem and then a singular leaf. Now we'll compare that to the Virginia creeper, which has a totally different configuration, but remotely looks similar. The Virginia creeper looks quite similar, except it has tendrils that grow on tendrils. It also tends to have three little leaves or five little leaves very near the tip. So this is a Virginia creeper. This is toxic. This we don't want. Plus, it also does not break easily, whereas the Smilax does. The Smilax can have little leaves at the end, but they're singular. Whereas These are not. And right next to it is a wild grape. Now the wild grape has a singular leaf, as you can tell, but it's kind of heart-shaped and pointy, got teeth on it. But it has single tendrils. Now you could eat the wild grape leaf, but these are very, very bitter. And they also are pretty tough.
See how some folks say these taste like asparagus? Because they kind of look like asparagus, but you know, they really don't taste like asparagus. And then some people say, well, they taste like green beans, and they kind of say that because they do kind of snap like green beans, but they don't taste like green beans either. They taste like Smilax. These are one of the most prime edibles of spring or summer, depending upon where you live. In North America, they grow basically east of the Rocky Mountains, but they also grow elsewhere in the world, particularly Southern Europe with the Smilax aspera. There are some 300 species of Smilax, so there's one near you. I think the root of the Smilax is overrated. You know, when young, they can be eaten as they are, just cooked. But once it gets an age to it, it gets kind of tough. Not only that, but it's also 9/10 fiber and only 1/10 flour, so 10 pounds of this, plus a day's work will only get you 1 pound of pink flour. It's really not worth it in terms of calories in, calories out. However, this starch was used to hold together such things as cornmeal and other primitive breads. It can be used as a thickener, like cornstarch, so a little goes a long way. Also, this root was the original source for the drinks sarsaparilla and root beer. In fact, on my website, I have a real Smilax beer recipe, so go to eattheweeds.com and look that up. Incidentally, the young leaves of the Smilax are also edible. You can add them to your soups and salads. Smilaxes are a good source of antioxidants and can help with, oddly enough, rheumatism. The name Smilax comes from a Greek myth with several variations. Smilax was a beautiful young nymph who fell in love with a mortal young Spartan named Crocos. Crocos, however, had an affair with the goddess Hermes, who, for reasons we shall not discuss here, turned him into a flower we call crocus, also from where we get saffron. It's also probably why when someone dies we say they croak. Smilax was so heartbroken that her hothrob was now, shall we say, well, a blooming idiot, that Aphrodite took pity on her. And now Aphrodite had several love affairs of her own, and a love child we call Eros and Cupid. She turned Smilax into a vine so she could always be with Crocos forever. In our next episode of Botanical Mythology, we will learn how Zeus, who forced Aphrodite to get married, became pregnant himself out of wedlock and had a child come out of his forehead, fully formed, wearing battle armor. And you thought soap operas were new. A little olive oil, a little soy sauce, a little pepper, oh, Smilax, wonderful meal. I want to thank you for joining me on my 115th video here on eattheweeds.com about Smilax. Smilax too. If you want to know more about edible plants, go to eattheweeds.com. I'm approaching 700 plants on my website. If you want to receive my newsletter, send me an email address. And if you want to know where and when my classes are, you can go to the website also. By the way, I also have there an international list of foraging instructors. So until next time, this is Green Dean. I want you to think green. I want you to eat green. I want you to live green too. And that includes, Crocus made a mistake. Toodles. Oh my gosh. Finger licking good.